If you receive Speaker Gingrich actionable intelligence about the location of Taliban leader Mullah Muhammad Omar inside Pakistan, would you authorize a unilateral operation, much like the one that killed bin Laden, with or without the Pakistani government knowing, even if the consequence was an end to all U.S.-Pakistani cooperation?
Well, let me go back to set the stage as you did a while ago. Bin Laden plotted deliberately bombing American embassies, bombing the USS Cole, and killing 3,100 Americans, and his only regret was he didn't kill more. Now, he's not a Chinese dissident. You know, the analogy that Congressman Paul used was utterly irrational. A Chinese dissident who comes here seeking freedom is not the same as a terrorist who goes to Pakistan seeking asylum. Furthermore, when you give a country $20 billion and you learn that they have been hiding, I mean, nobody believes that bin Laden was sitting in a compound in a military city 1 mile from the National Defense University and the Pakistanis didn't know it. Now, we're in South Carolina. South Carolina in the Revolutionary War had a young 30-year-old named Andrew Jackson. He was sabered by a British officer and wore a scar his whole life. Andrew Jackson had a pretty clear-cut idea about America's enemies. Killed them.